Hello everybody, this is the Lossy 88, and I am back today with another Buffy the Vampire Slayer, and this is Season 8, Book 4, and apparently this is the finale. I didn't know that. I thought there was like 3 more books, don't know why, but apparently this is the finale of season 8, sorry. And I found this out because I ordered the next 2 books, books 5 and 6, from my local comic book shop, who has been buying these in for me, and they took my order. And then they called me back a week later when they got around to it, and they told me that there is not a book 5 and 6 in season 8. So, I don't know. I just told them to order me the next 2 books, whether that be season 9 or somewhere in between, if there's a between story. This cover art is amazing. I think all of the books have beautiful cover arts. The colors, the lighting. If you can see how stunning this is. We've got Angel, Buffy, and Giles. Kind of feel like they go for quite a minimalist approach on these books, on the covers. It's got all the information you need on the side there. Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Season 8, Book 4. So that's the important part. Now, I got a little bit greedy, and I read book 3 in 1 day, and I don't recommend you do that. Not because the books aren't good, but because you feel a little bit lost when you finished it. I think, at least for me, the best way to read these books is a partial chapter at a time, like 20 to 30 pages, because they're so expensive. They're like 25 to 30 pounds each, and if you can read it in 1 day, I mean, that's great. I can read it again, sure, and I probably will read season 8 all the way through to the end of season 8, so the 4 books, I'll probably read those again just to go back and really focus on the artwork and look through it again. I don't plan on getting rid of these books. So let's read the back. So this is the comic version of Buffy. It's very different to the style on the front, but I think they're just amazing nonetheless. And it says, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Season 8, Volume 4. Joss Whedon's Buffy the Vampire Slayer concludes its 8th season, only in comics. Season 8's Big Bad is unmasked. As the story crosses through time and space, the future of the world is changed, and Twilight's twisted plan is revealed. Taking the fight home to Sunnydale, the Slayer army faces catastrophic losses as Buffy reunites with Angel and Spike, scrambling to end the violence and save mankind. This deluxe edition collects Twilight and Last Gleaming, the final two arcs of season 8, along with a standalone story starring Riley and an expanded sketchbook section from series artist Georges Gentil. Says the Huffington Post says Buffy season 8 continues to evoke the tone and savvy emotional mix of the show. And Comics Alliance says Meltzer pulls off an incredible 1-2 punch, deftly jumping from one emotional high to a drastically different one, leaving readers' heads spinning and me laughing uproariously. So I'm definitely excited to see who Twilight is. I think I know, but that was because of a spoiler in the book one end comic. They do it a bit at the end. The last like 20 pages is all sketches and things like that, and why they chose to draw things a certain way. So I'm gonna open this up. Okay, so we'll look at the back cover art. There isn't any. Okay, so that's quite unusual. Normally we have some sort of image here. Girls Entertainment Network says, Meltzer's talent speaks for itself. I wouldn't be surprised if letters started pouring in today for him to return to season 9. And then from Newsarama, Meltzer's take on Buffy season 8 definitely has the energy that I would associate with, say, season 3 of the television series, and the art really only gets better. Season 3, what happened in season 3? Oh, that was the one with where Faith came in. Yeah, that one was pretty good. And then this is from IGN. It says, the true star of this series is Georges Gentil. He so effectively renders these characters on the page at this point that they emote all the idiosyncrasies that the television actors themselves established years ago. Very true. Very, very true. And then we also have a little bit of information here. And it says, Following a losing battle against Twilight's insurmountable army, Buffy finds herself imbued with the mysterious new superpowers that may turn the tide of this seemingly endless fight. As she tries to pick up the pieces in the aftermath, discovering allies gone missing and the unexplained massacres of Slayer squads around the globe, Buffy goes straight to Twilight himself for a confrontation that rocks the Earth's foundations and reveals the identity of the Slayer's greatest foe to date. Angel and Spike make their season 8 debut, each with vital information that will ultimately lead Buffy back home to Sunnydale. While the Slayers fight an onslaught of demons raining down on the Earth, Buffy faces the ultimate betrayal and suffers great sacrifices to put an end to Twilight and save the world from the ultimate destruction. The losses will be great, and when the dust settles, everyone and everything will be different. And as per usual, what I'm going to do is show you some of the first pages. I'm not really going to look because I don't want to see. But oh wow, look at do they make a poster of that? Oh my god, that's amazing. I want that so bad as a poster. That is beautiful. That is stunning. Okay, so here's the contents, what we have to include. And then there's something. There's Willow. Can you see Willow there? And some sort of god. So I'm just going to flip through the pages, not really looking at anything, not really looking. I'm sorry, but I did look at this. It says Twilight chapter 1. Buffy has a thing superpowers. I love the comedy in this. It's just so dark and funny and kind of inappropriate, but that's why we love it. So that is book 4. Can't wait to start reading this one. I'm definitely going to take my time with this one. I said I'd take my time with the last one. It didn't happen. I couldn't help myself. I literally turned the camera off and I started reading it. So I'm really excited to read this one, and I know it's going to be at least like probably a month or more before I get the next books, season 9. So I gotta wait and be patient, but I'm paying extra for these hardback editions. Oh, it's a big face of Giles. Mr. Giles. Hi, Mr. Giles. I just love the quality of these books. Normally I would never pay £30 for a freaking comic book, but the problem is I looked on eBay and there's a lot on there, but they all seem to be the paperback ones, or they're actually higher in price than what the comic book guy can get me them new. I think they're just trying to make their profit, that's fine. But it does make me a little bit discouraged on these, just purely because I can't get them really easy. I can't walk into a store and buy them. So never mind, he said he's going to order more than the 2 that I ordered. So then if I want more, he'll have them in stock without having to pay another lot of postage. So that's pretty cool. Awesome. So, yeah, this is this book. And I'm going to go and start reading it, but not read all of it. I'm going to be good. No, I just read a few pages.